In the last video, I talked about how the direction of a chemical reaction is dictated by the delta G for the reaction. We saw that when the delta G for a reaction is negative, the reaction proceeds spontaneously from left to right and is called energetically favorable. When delta G for a reaction is positive, the reaction proceeds spontaneously from right to left and is called energetically unfavorable. When delta G for a reaction is zero, neither the forward nor the backward direction is favored, and the reaction is said to be at equilibrium. Given enough time, reactions that start with a positive or negative delta G will eventually reach equilibrium. Sometimes it is desirable for the cell to carry out a reaction that is energetically unfavorable. For example, consider the addition of ammonia to the amino acid glutamate to form the amino acid glutamine. This reaction has a standard delta G of positive 14.2 kilojoules per mole. Remember that the delta G under cellular conditions will be different from the delta G under standard conditions, but for simplicity, let's assume that the delta G is the same as the standard delta G. Thus, if a cell wants to make some glutamine from glutamate, it has a problem, because in this reaction, the left side of the equation is favored. To solve this problem, it might be possible to change the relative concentrations of the reactants such that the reaction would become favorable. The cell could do this by increasing the concentration of glutamate, for example, or decreasing the concentration of glutamine. Such changes in concentration would affect delta G and could, in principle, make the delta G negative. However, it is usually not possible for the cell to manipulate the concentrations of reagents as much as would be required to make an energetically unfavorable reaction favorable. An alternate strategy to drive an unfavorable reaction forward is to somehow connect or couple that reaction to an energetically favorable reaction, that is, a reaction with a negative delta G. I'll explain what I mean by coupling reactions in a minute, but for now you need to realize that when you couple reactions together, you can add the delta Gs together. If the total delta G for both reactions is negative, then the entire process will proceed spontaneously. This strategy is the one favored in living systems. The main reaction that cells use to drive unfavorable reactions forward is the hydrolysis of adenosine triphosphate, or ATP, to form adenosine diphosphate, or ADP, and a free phosphate ion. Biochemists often abbreviate the phosphate ion using P with a subscripted letter I, which stands for inorganic phosphate. ATP is a nucleotide containing the monosaccharide ribose with the base adenine attached to carbon 1 and three phosphate groups attached to carbon 5. The important part of the molecule for our discussion now is the triphosphate part, the reaction in which a water molecule cleaves the third phosphate group from ATP to form ADP, an inorganic phosphate, or PI, is energetically favorable. Because this reaction is so widely used in cells, it is worthwhile to take a moment to understand why it is energetically favorable. First, you can see that removing a phosphate from the end of ATP allows some of the negative charges on the oxygen atoms to separate from each other. Because like charges repel, moving some of the negative charges away from each other is a favorable process. Second, the electrons on the phosphate groups can be distributed over more oxygen atoms in the products than they can in the reactants. This is because two more oxygen atoms are available that can take negative charge. In the language of organic chemistry, it is said that the products have more resonance structures than the reactants. As an example, the phosphate ion has four resonance structures as shown. Spreading the negative charges over a greater number of atoms means more stability. Third, the total surface area of the products is greater than that of the reactants. This allows the products to make more interactions with water than the reactants can. The products are said to be more highly solvated. They make more interactions with the solvent. These interactions are energetically favorable, so the products are preferred. The standard delta G of hydrolysis of ATP to ADP and phosphate is minus 30.5 kilojoules per mole. This is a convenient amount of energy that can be used to drive many unfavorable reactions forward. For example, recall that the standard delta G for the formation of glutamine from glutamate is 14.2 kilojoules per mole. If the cell could somehow couple the reactions together, it could use the energy released from ATP hydrolysis to power the synthesis of glutamine. This is, in fact, exactly what happens. But how? Let's look at how these reactions are coupled together to illustrate how reactions are coupled together more generally. The coupled reaction proceeds in two steps. In the first step, a phosphate from ATP is transferred to glutamic acid to make a phosphorylated intermediate and ADP. In the second step, ammonia reacts with the intermediate to eject the phosphate group and form glutamine. Overall, both reactions have taken place. Ammonia has been added to glutamate to make glutamine, and ATP has been hydrolyzed to phosphate and ADP. But the reactions do not happen separately. The mechanism requires reactants from each reaction to interact with each other to form and resolve an intermediate molecule. Keep in mind that the reaction is catalyzed by an enzyme, which brings the different reactants together in specific ways to facilitate the reaction. As mentioned previously, when two reactions are coupled in this way, we can add the delta G's of the individual reactions to get an overall delta G for the total reaction, which in this case is minus 16.3 kilojoules per mole. The entire process is energetically favorable. ATP hydrolysis to ADP and phosphate is the reaction most commonly used to drive unfavorable reactions in the cell. But what if a desired reaction is very unfavorable, such that hydrolysis of ATP to ADP does not provide enough energy? To drive such reactions forward, the cell has other options. For example, two phosphates can be cleaved from ATP to make adenosine monophosphate along with the pyrophosphate ion, abbreviated PPI. The pyrophosphate can itself be cleaved to form two phosphate ions. Both of these steps are energetically favorable. Overall, for hydrolysis of ATP to AMP and two phosphates, the standard delta G is minus 66.1 kilojoules per mole, more than twice the energy that is released when ATP is hydrolyzed to ADP and phosphate. An example of another reaction that can be used to drive unfavorable reactions is hydrolysis of phosphocreatine to form creatine and phosphate. The standard delta G for this reaction is minus 43.1 kilojoules per mole, and so it also can provide more energy to drive unfavorable reactions than hydrolysis of ATP to ADP. I have given just two examples. In principle, any reaction with a substantially negative delta G can be used by the cell to drive unfavorable reactions forward. Having established some essential concepts relating to the thermodynamics of chemical reactions, we can move on in the next video to explain how these concepts help us understand metabolism.